In this video, we're going to learn how to make a logo on Canva and also convert it into 3G. Let's jump in and do this. Welcome, entrepreneurs, to African Multi Design, a channel dedicated in helping your small business grow and thrive online. My name is Zanele, and as I said earlier on, we're going to look at how to design a 3D logo using our phones this time. If you missed the 3D logo design on the computer, you're welcome to click on the link on the description below and you can go through that. So today we're looking on the phone and we're going to follow three steps to get to the 3D logo. So please take note the websites that we're using, three of them. All the links are on the description below. And if you know a section of the video, you can click on the timestamp and jump through to exactly where you need to get to. So let's jump in. Once you land on Canva, the first thing that you're going to do is to search for a logo because you want to design a logo. And Canva is going to give you different options that are available, even generic. So the first one is generic, but I know we would like to design a cafe logo because our customer sells food. Then you scroll and search through until you find the one that you like. I like this one. Then you just click once on it and it opens up for you to change the design. And if you like the black, you can leave the black alone. If you don't, you just click once and you click on the color and you choose the color that you like and it changes like that. So I like the black and I like to keep things simple. I just leave it like that. So we're doing a design for Hlengiwe. So I've highlighted the text. I'm going to call it, her shop is Hlengi's Kitchen. And then you just change the text like that. And she's actually in MDN, Soweto. So we just change it to MDN, Soweto. And then it changes like that. I think it's a little bit small, don't you? Let's make it a little bit big so that the convo pops, the logo pops. I like this size. So you just tweak it this way. If you want to change the Canva, or rather if you want to create the logo from scratch using your own design, you're welcome to choose a blank Canva. This time we're just choosing a template. So the text for me looks a little bit small, so we're going to drag and make it a little bit big and easy like that. I want to make it bold, so you scroll at the bottom and you make it bold like that. So I'm happy with that. It just looks a little bit out of sync, and you tweak it like that. And same as the Soweto, you tweak it like that. I think our icon is also a little bit small, and I'm happy with that. And let's make the Soweto bold as well. As easy as that. I'm happy with our logo. Now I'm going to download the logo. I'm going to click on the download and Canva will download it to my gallery file. So you leave it as a PNG file. Because I'm using a free version, then I can't use the transparency on Canva. At the moment, I cannot, as an entrepreneur, afford the paid version. So that's the cool thing about Canva. That's step number one done. Now we're going to go to step number two so we can remove background for free. You go to the Remove BG website and you go upload this image that we just downloaded from our Canva. And now I'm choosing this one, Hlengi's Kitchen, and I'm uploading it to the brand, the BG. It has removed the background. I just click on download. And then it downloads the one that has no background. And I'm happy it's downloaded. Step number two is done. I don't want to download it again. Then step number three, you need to find the link on the bottom of the page on the description below where you can find the converter that I've saved. So how it works is you're going to click on the link. The link will automatically download the 3G converter to the mock-up. It's going to download the mock-up to your gallery on your phone. Then you need to find to have software on your phone that will convert that mock-up into a PSD file so that you can upload it here. I'll write the steps on the description for you so that you know how to download the 3D mock-up. Once the mock-up is downloaded, it looks like this. So I'm gonna just minimize on my file on my phone so I can show you. So you go to your files and it would download it to your files and it would be on your downloads. And once it's on your downloads, it's gonna look like that. It's gonna say 3D glass window logo mockup zip. It's going to have a zip file on it. If it's zipped like this, you won't be able to use it. You need to open the mockup. In other words, you need to extract it. So you need to have on your phone an extractor like mine. You see, mine has an extract too, and then you can extract it to your phone. And then it will ask you for a password. And don't copy and paste the password. Type it in. So it's inspiringb.com. And when you click on OK, it will ask you, do you want to extract? And you would say yes. And then it extracts the file. So, and it overrides it because I've extracted it before. So once it extracts the file, you can then find your file on your phone gallery and then you're able to load it on Photopea. Once you get to photopea.com, then you're going to go to open from computer and you're going to go find that file that you just downloaded. So my suggestion is go look on the files of your phone and see where it's saved to, and then go extract it to where you can find it. And you're looking for a file that says PSD image like this one, and click on the PSD image. It'll load like it's loading now, and it will load this way. So once it has loaded, you would click where it says layers there, where it says layers, and you open the layers. You double click where it says logo twice, and then it will show you the text for Inspiring B. You would then hide the text for Inspiring B, and then you're gonna go back to your display, and it would be blank with no text, and it'll show you just the display. Then you're gonna go to File, and you're gonna find your 3G logo that you've just designed. And you're going to click on open and place, and you're going to go to the image that you've just saved for your downloads. So let's go look at our downloads, the one that we just removed the background, and it will load like that. Then once it has loaded the logo you just designed, you click and you drag it so that it covers the whole page. Then you click and you hold it and you size it the way that you would like your logo to display. Once you're happy with your 2D logo, because this one is still 2D, then you're gonna go File and you're gonna say Save Smart Objects. Just check the lines. As soon as the software changes it to a smart object, the lines will disappear. And then it updates as smart object. You saw that message that comes through. Once it's changed as a smart object, you're gonna click on this 3D glass. You're gonna click on it once so that it converts the logo to a 3D. So just be a little bit patient because it takes a couple of moments to convert, and then it would change it to a 3D logo. And there you go. Nice and easy. That's how you do a 3D logo from 2D to 3D, and then you can download it. As soon as you're happy with it and it looks like this, you go File and you click Add Export As, and then you can export it as a PNG. I think my Wi-Fi is a little bit slow today. And there you go. It downloads the file. And when you click on open, it will also be on your gallery. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Please add comments at the bottom of the page. But I will see you next time. And don't forget to subscribe. Thank you.